Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to another episode. I think today is going to be a good old driveway session. See, this is just
bloody deep.
Pinnacles for us, yeah.
Might seem a bit overkill.
I think I've done a diff center. That is my analysis at the moment. So the other night I went for a run with Dave from work, and as I was leaving the car park, I turned out and just heard this grinding sound like a bag of nuts and bolts that were grinding in my drum. So I thought something happened with the brake, but I had brakes that are all working sweet. But every time I slowed down, I could hear this grinding again. So I just babied it all the way home and pulled off the drum just to check the brake, but that was all right. And then I jacked up the other tire over there. And then when I spin this, I can feel this clicking noise in here, clicking noise through there. So I can only assume after 187,000 kilometers, I think that's what I've got on my odometer. I think it's finally let go, which is actually pretty good, surprisingly. So it's 2015 model, late 2015, and every day of its life until 3 months ago, it was towing my trailer.
That trailer there. It's a dual axle 8x5 trailer.
Yeah, tradie trailer. I reckon it weighs somewhere about in between 1.5 to 1.8 ton. So with that being towed with that every day, the bigger wheels, all the different changes that this car's undergone over the years, I think it's done pretty good. So I put it on Instagram, bit of fun as I always do. And Thomas hit me up and said, I've got a diff for you. Diff center out of a PX1. He's a mechanic as well. He said they're the same, just the locker pin is just in a slightly different position, but it's fine. He ran it in his. He had a manual car, a manual Ranger, but the ratios are a bit different, so he took it out and sold it to me. So I picked that up last night, and today we're going to learn how to change the diff center. It's not going to be a how-to video or anything, it's just going to be me messing about in the driveway. So, but I haven't dropped the diff oil yet. So that's one thing I'm going to need to do this morning. I just got to run up to Bunnings or somewhere. I just need a different socket for the diff drain plugs and filler plug. But I'll run up now, go grab those. We'll drop the oil and see what comes out. Should be a fun day. Hopefully it doesn't take too long because I want to go fishing tomorrow. So I need to tow the boat. I mean, it doesn't sound as bad today, but we're going to drain the oil and see what happens. There you go, it's done. I mean, it's not the nicest colour, but I don't have any metal coming out. There's actually nothing, not even, well, there's just the tiniest little bit of swarf on there, but that's kind of standard. Well, if it's not my diff, and now I'm spinning, I just spun it then, like if I spin these, there's no clicking in there. Just feels pretty smooth actually. So, I don't know what it is. Well, I guess on the bright side, if it's not my diff, at least I've done the oil again. So that's a bonus. Because there's literally, like I just, it's just your general, that was it there, your general swarf, just real fine dust, metal dust. My next question would be, maybe it's the transfer case. And in that case, that sucks. Another bonus is I don't have to pull the axles out and do all that side of things, but I don't know. Literally nothing came out, so I just don't know. I might get under there, put it in and just wiggle the tail shaft and see what happens, but well, seeing as though I don't have anything that come out of the diff, let's talk to me mate Alex. He's one of the mechanics at Carter Ford, and he said it's interesting and weird as well. So I'm just gonna throw some oil back in, maybe just take it for a drive, because nothing, I mean, nothing seems to be crunching. It feels nice and smooth. So, I don't know. Rightio, and then, so that diff's all filled up. And then if I spin this again, everything seems all right. Definitely no clicking or anything. Oh. No clicking. Good thing, I guess. So I'm just going to tighten up this handbrake as well, and then I might take it for a little drive. I've also got to align the wheels a bit better. It's hanging out to one side a little bit, so I might bring it along with me. Find some flat car park somewhere and we can sort that out as well while we're at it. Stay tuned. Perfectly honest with you, it feels pretty good. I don't know. I'll put a video that I took from the other night in here so you can see what it sounded like when I was twisting it when I got home from a run the other night on Thursday. As you can see, it sounded terrible, but I don't know, maybe it was just due for a bit of just an oil change, but it's all good. I'm going to go find a car park and give this thing a bit of a wheel alignment. So I've just found this car park not far from where I live. And I'll show you what I mean with my car. Hopefully this is sort of pretty flat. But if you look at this side here, with how much poke I've got outside the mudguard there, it's very little. There you go. And then on the passenger side, I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. Yeah, it's... Oh. Triple what it is on the driver's side. So what I'm going to do is jump under there. Maybe that works better. Oh, there we go. That'll show you. And then around the other side. So with my car, I've found that when I'm towing and things like that, if I set the panhard at the back there to about 10 mil to the driver's side, when it squats, it sits over and it ends up evening it out nicer. And then I figured with extra load when I'm going camping and everything like that, once I put food, beer, water, all that, fill it up, it shifts over as well when it squats. So that's what I've kind of figured out over the last 4 or 5 months or however long I've had the coil conversion in for. So check it. Got one more click and I reckon we're good to go. There we go. That in there, that on there. Yeah, so that's sticking out probably 35. It's in the same sort of region where I was with the leaves. And on this side, it's just a tad. Yeah, it's probably 5. I'd say 5-7 mil. Yeah, so it's been a little bit of a fun morning. I mean, I don't think we like. No, I've been driving around for about half an hour, 45 minutes with the diff, and there's no noises. Maybe it just needed an oil change, so I guess that's all good. So we'll see what happens. At least we've got a spare diff now if something ever does happen. But like I said, it's got 187,000 on the clock and it's had a pretty good life. So if it does go, then it's no big deal. It's just part of it. But yeah, thanks for watching. That'll be it for today. Gonna go prep the boat for tomorrow. Go fishing. But thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Another driveway sesh turned into a car park sesh. Thanks to these guys for letting me use their car park. But yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe. There's lots of videos coming through. So thanks for watching, thanks for the support. Just clicked over 11,000, so thank you for that to everyone that's subscribed. And no worries, guys. Have a good one. No.